Welcome back to the next installment of World Rhino Week, where in this video I will be talking about the Sumatran rhino, the smallest species of rhino which have gone through a significant decline in recent years. I hope you enjoy. Sumatran rhinos, as mentioned, are the smallest extant species of rhino, as well as being the one with the most hair. As they are the smallest of the five rhinos, they typically stand at 1.3 meters at the shoulder, lengths of 2.4 to 3.2 meters, and weights of around 700 kilograms. Unlike the Indian and Javan rhinos, Sumatran rhinos instead possess two horns, even though they are unrelated to the African species. They have also been found to be the most basal of extant rhinos, and from morphological and molecular studies, and have been found to be most closely related to the extinct woolly rhinos of Eurasia. The hair of Sumatran rhinos can be dense or sparse depending on the location, and is reddish-brown in colour, and has been known to grow out in captivity and become shaggier, likely because of less abrasion from walking through dense vegetation. Two thick folds of skin encircle the body behind the front legs and before the hind legs, also possessing a smaller fold of skin around their necks. Rhinos prefer dense tropical rainforests at low or high altitudes, preferring dense secondary forests where low-growing plants are more abundant, primarily feeding on shrubs, fruits, and leaves. They are fast and agile, being able to traverse steep hills, riverbanks, and mountains at up to 40 kilometers per hour with ease, utilizing their horns and rims of hard skin and cartilage on their nose and head to break through vegetation. They are the most vocal of all rhino species, likely due to their habitation of more remote environments, with some sounds being loud enough to make iron bars in zoo enclosures where they have been studied to vibrate, being able to carry over 10 kilometers. They are mainly solitary aside from when coming together to mate or to rear calves, and their reproductive habits have been able to be studied in captivity. It has been found that courtship is most similar to that of the black rhino, and that young males are often very aggressive with females, sometimes injuring or even killing them during courtship. In the wild, females can run away if they face this, but in captivity, they cannot, and this inability to escape may partly contribute to the low success rate of captive breeding programs, which alongside hardships in encouraging mating and fertility, as well as low population size and gestation time, has made it even more difficult to assist these animals in a secure environment. Sumatran rhinos were once quite numerous throughout Southeast Asia, ranging from the foothills of the Himalayas through Myanmar, Thailand, and the Indonesian islands of Borneo and Sumatra, hence the name. They have, however, suffered catastrophic losses in the last few years through poaching for their horns as well as rampant deforestation. The forests are both cleared for palm oil as well as being logged for the desirability of rare woods such as murbel and cimarram, which has in turn isolated populations, and thus increasing inbreeding depression, now being found in only the most inaccessible mountainous areas of Borneo and Sumatra. Fewer than 100 individuals are estimated to remain today, and they may even number 30 or less due to potential overestimation, although future countings are needed to see where they are really at, something made even more difficult due to their mostly inaccessible habitats. Rhinos now only exist in protected areas where they are physically guarded by protection units that patrol their habitats, and as this video has shown, they face extraordinary threats, and with their rate of decline being more rapid than any other species of rhino, conservation efforts and poaching eradication are most definitely key in ensuring these unique animals are able to survive. With that, I hope you enjoyed this installment of World Rhino Week, and that you are now more caught up with and invested in the plight these animals face, what they are like, and what is being done to save them. And if you want to further support rhino conservation, there is a donation link in the description and in the comments. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all next time with the final installment covering the Javan rhino.